What's up, guys? I'm Mike with Chaos Aquaculture, and I'm going to show you how to ship some corals. Get asked a lot how to ship corals. There's a lot of people that are getting into fragging and buying and selling and you know, trading coral like their baseball cards and sending them through the mail, and we actually buy from a lot of people as well. So we get asked how to ship. We've also gotten a lot of compliments on the way we ship, and I'm going to show you how to do that real quick. We're gonna start out by bagging the coral. It's the most expensive part. I'm not actually gonna use coral, I'm just gonna use some water, but you'll get the idea. So I like to take a 2 ounce cup and I cut the bottom of it, you can see here. And what I do is I stick the coral in there. So I'm gonna take the plug and I'm gonna stick it right through that cup. And what that does is it protects the coral during shipping. So now just pretend that there's a coral glued to there. We're gonna get a bit of water. And now, make sure the coral is completely submersed in water, and you're gonna tighten this up and get all the air out, like I just did. I don't like to ship with any air in there, so no matter which way FedEx or UPS decides to kick your package, the coral won't be out of the water. So you're gonna tighten this up until it's pretty stiff. You can see it's getting to the point where that wants to start curling on its own. That's how you know it's tight enough. You're gonna make a little loop and pinch it off. Take your rubber band, once around the loop, twice around the loop, three times, and now we're gonna wrap underneath the whole thing. And then to stop it, back around the loop. That will not leak, that will not come apart. So once you have the coral bagged up, the second thing you're gonna do is you're gonna double bag it. We always double bag. I like to use a 4 mil bag. They're thick, it is very hard to puncture, and your coral will be safe in it. We're gonna do the same exact thing we did before. Once it wants to curl on its own, we're tight enough, we're gonna make that loop. Once, twice, three times, and now around the bottom. All right, next step, you're gonna need a box. So we wanna pick the right size box to ship in. For this, obviously, I would use a smaller box, but for the purpose of the video, I'm gonna use this larger one. If you don't do this all the time, every day, day in and day out, you're gonna wanna get yourself one of these cooler boxes. There are build-a-boxes, you can make your own using insulation that you purchase at your local hardware store and cut out. But for safety's sake, especially if you're unsure, if you've never done this, I recommend just picking up a cooler box. These are phenomenal. You don't have to build, you don't have to cut, and you don't have to figure out how to get a 4x8 sheet of insulation foam home in your car. So the first thing I do is I'm gonna take that, I'm gonna take some tissue paper here, craft paper, you can use newspaper, old magazines, it doesn't matter. Just use something. And we're gonna stuff the bottom of the box with it. You're gonna kind of create a little bed for that coral to go in. You're gonna take your double bag coral. There's the bed in the bottom of the box. And you're gonna stick it right in there, right in the center of it. I then take more paper. I like to fold it loosely a little bit. No need to crease it. And you're gonna stuff that right on top. So now it's got a bed of paper and a blanket of paper over the coral. Now, before we started rolling the video, I went ahead and I cut a piece of cardboard, be whatever you have laying around, to fit there. We want to stick that over top of that. And what that's going to do is that's going to separate our temperature control device, whether it be heat or cold that we decide to use, from our coral. Once that cardboard is in there, I then use more paper and go on top of the cardboard. We want to try our hardest to keep the temperature in the bags the same as it was in the aquarium. Now, it's going to climb a little or drop a little bit during shipping. That's natural, but we want to minimize the amount of climb or drop that we get. So, if this was all we were shipping in this box. At this point, I would be ready to add my heat or my ice. That's the way it looks. The cardboard is underneath there. Let me pull it out so you can see real quick. And now we're gonna add our temperature control. Ice is a lot easier to use than heat. Ice, you don't have to be as afraid of as you do with heat. With ice, let's say we're shipping this to somebody else here in Florida like we are, we definitely wanna put ice in it because it's still ridiculously hot out. We're gonna take a little bit of paper. We're gonna take our ice pack. And we're just gonna wrap it up like they do sandwiches when you're at the deli. Once that's wrapped up there, we put a little piece of tape on it so it doesn't come undone. And you can go ahead and stick that right in the middle, right there. Now that ice pack should last, no problems, a solid 20 to 24 hours or so. Once that ice pack's in there, I then take loose paper and loosely stuff it on top. You want to fill the rest of this gap so the coral doesn't flop around in here. Now, if I was only shipping one coral, like I said earlier, I would not use a box this large unless it was a really big coral. You want to get a box a little bit closer in size to what you're going to ship, but for the purpose of this video, we're going to use this. Now, I will say this, the harsher the weather you're shipping to or shipping from, the larger the box you want. It's going to keep temperature much more stable that way, and the more padding that you can put in there. So that's with ice. If we're using ice, now I got the padding. Put the lid on. I would tape this up around, stick it in the box, and send it. Heat is another story. Heat is something you have to be very cautious with. You always want to err on the side of cold when it comes to shipping coral. Corals can recover from being cold fairly quickly, but heat will kill them fairly quickly. So for me, I want to use heat anytime the temperature doesn't ever get above, say, 68 degrees at the destination. Or if it drops anywhere below, say, 58 degrees. Anywhere there or below, it's going to get heat in the package. Anywhere above, say, 68, 70 degrees, and I'm very cautious with using heat. Sometimes I'll even put it on the outside. So with the heat pack, you're going to want to open her up, obviously. Never use glove warmers. I can't stress this enough. Glove warmers get way too hot. They will kill the coral. These are heat packs specifically made. You can see right there, it says small pets shipping warmer, and it's a 40-hour heat pack that I'm using. This will not overheat. Now, you still can't touch the coral with it. The air gap and the cardboard and the other stuff you saw me put in is still important, but it won't get as hot as glove warmers. You wanna shake it up pretty good? Take your piece of paper. Same as we did the ice pack, you're gonna wrap it up. Now, there's a red line here. That red line, we can't cover up too heavily. That's where the breather is, and this thing actually needs oxygen for it to work. So I'm gonna go ahead and fold this up. And that's why we use paper, because it's breathable. You never wanna wrap this in plastic or else it won't heat. Once I have this wrapped up nicely, I like to put it on the lid. And then I'm gonna tape this to the lid. I want this heat pack as far away from the coral as humanly possible during shipping. According to the packaging, these heat packs raise a 1 foot square box about 10 degrees. So always keep that in mind when you're going to ship. So heat pack taped to the box. I did not cover the center because that's where that red strip is. Coral's in there with the air gap. I'm gonna put the stuffing in. And now we have that solid space in between where the heat pack's gonna be and where the actual coral is, and that's what's gonna keep this coral alive. That's what's gonna keep it from overheating. This heat pack will stabilize the temperature in here, not allow it to drop too much, and your coral will get there safe and sound. Once that's in, taper up, boxer, and shipper. You want to ship your corals as late in the day as possible. Don't try not to drop these things off at 9 a.m. with FedEx. The less time it's in the bag, the less time it's in the box, the higher the survivability rate is. I'm really proud to say that here at Chaos Aquaculture, our survivability rate is greater than 99%. We rarely have an issue. We've had packages get delayed before and all the corals still alive, arrive healthy even 2 days later. Of course, mistakes happen, things happen, and we try to mitigate those. This is the way that I do it. So, hope it helps.